How's it going, everybody? Welcome back. And today we're going to be discussing whether or not NordVPN's pricing is justified considering the value that you're getting out of NordVPN. So before we begin, if at any point you guys would like to check for links to pricing and discounts, including this discount right here, where you'll be getting an extra month rather than just the usual 3 months for free, you'll be getting 4 months for free, as if you're paying $318 a month rather than $367, I believe. That was the regular deal that's available for everybody. So make sure to claim this deal, this extra month, if you guys are interested. In the description down below, you'll find everything you need, including a full review that'll give you more of an in-depth look into the privacy policies, speed streaming and torrenting capabilities, as well as security and features. So keep that in mind if you guys are interested. Now, what are you getting with NordVPN? With this value, I mean, considering you're paying, let's say you're not going to get the 1 month plan, right? Unless you just want to try NordVPN out, since there's no free trial, you can give the 1 month plan a shot and perhaps get a refund if you're not satisfied. But most people are going to be getting either the 1 year plan or the 2 year plan, both of which are actually quite reasonably priced. So you'll be paying roughly $60 for the single year here. And you'll be getting a good discount here. Instead of 24 months, you're getting 28 months for $90. So, you know, that's pretty good. You know, you're going to pay that $90 and forget about getting another subscription for the next 28 months. So not bad at all. So what are you getting with NordVPN? I mean, are you just paying for 28 months of some whatever service, or is it actually a pretty good service? Now, of course, if you're looking for the full info, the full in-depth look, definitely check the review below. But I'm going to give you guys a quick rundown. Now, first of all, we're going to go to the, oops, I minimized it. We're going to go to the settings, and right off the bat, you've got an ad blocker, okay? You've got the NordLynx protocol, which will make NordVPN the fastest protocol in the industry today. You've got not only just the regular kill switch, which will disable your internet when the VPN connection disconnects unexpectedly. You also get the app kill switch if you don't want your connection to drop completely if the VPN disconnects unexpectedly. Rather, you'll just be able to select selected apps that you'll pick, and these selected apps will actually disconnect from the, they'll be terminated. It's as if you're ending task from the task manager when the connection of the VPN drops. You've got split tunneling, of course, and custom DNS, which is an easy way to change your DNS. And you've got obfuscated servers, which only works with OpenVPN TCP, which will single out all the obfuscated servers on the map in the UI outside so that you're able to use these servers to bypass the Great Firewall of China, for example. And of course, you've got specialty servers. So, you know, you get plenty of features here for the price you're paying. And of course, by the way, if you didn't notice, if I switch to OpenVPN TCP, you'll be getting Onion over VPN. You'll be getting, excuse me, a dedicated IP and a double VPN. But it seems like with the latest update, when I switch to UDP, Onion over VPN disappears for whatever reason. It could be a bug, but that could also be deliberate. But for the most part, you know, I just recommend using NordLynx. That will be the best VPN. Best protocol to choose. So definitely stick with that. What else are you getting? You're getting very good streaming capabilities. So you'll be able to unblock up to 10 Netflix libraries. And these are just the confirmed libraries. You may as well test some of the servers yourself and try to unblock even more libraries and streaming services. But that's just Netflix, of course. And using Netflix as a reference, for example, ExpressVPN is able to unblock up to 18 Netflix libraries, 10 with Nord and 15 with Surfshark. So, you know, Surfshark is a little lacking behind when it comes to unblocking regions because it only has 60 regions, unlike Express's 94 and Surfshark's 65, for example, just comparing it with two other top VPNs. Really, Nord is one of them, definitely. top three VPNs, in my opinion. And but what you're getting with Nord here is a fair bit of value. So instead of the 3,000 servers with Express and 3,200 servers with Surfshark, you're getting over 5,300 servers. Unlike Express and Surfshark, you'll actually be able to browse these servers entirely. So you'll be able to see all of these servers one by one, checking the load, you know, whether or not you want something with a lot of load or less load, whatever it is that you're looking for, you know, you'll be able to get all of these servers in your grip and choose which one suits you best, really. So, of course, that includes all the other, not just the state servers, that includes all the other regions, and you can tell that there are plenty of servers in every single region. So you have a lot of choice here, a lot of choice. What else are you getting? Well, you're getting pretty good, a solid no-log policy. I wouldn't say it's as good as ExpressVPN's no-log policy or privacy policy, but it's still one of the best privacy policies in the industry. Again, for more information, check the review below. And you're also getting, well, the fastest speeds in the industry, to the best of my knowledge. A lot of other reviewers agree. NordVPN really is just... lately, they've broken records when it comes to speed. NordLynx seems to be like the exemplary WireGuard protocol, the next generation protocol, the WireGuard protocol. So great stuff when it comes to speed. So if that's what you're looking for, definitely, you're definitely going to find a lot of value here. So if you were to ask me if the pricing is justified for the value that you're getting, yeah, definitely. You're paying roughly $90, you're paying $89 for 28 months, well, 27 months, 28 if you click the link in the description. This is pretty good value for the price, really. So again, if you guys are interested in learning more about NordVPN, you'll find links in the description down below for the reviews, as well as the discounts, links to discounts and special deals. And if you have any other questions, feel free to comment down below and I'll do my best to answer all of your questions. Besides that, like and subscribe if you learned something and if you would like to stay up to date with everything cybersecurity and VPNs. Thank you guys very much for watching. I'll see you guys in the next one. Have a wonderful day.